charges there.
The Prime Minister today hit back at a fresh wave of criticism against the community charge by launching an attack in the Commons on the capital's Labour boroughs. She claimed extravagant spending was to blame for high poll tax and made a barely veiled threat against Lambeth, which is expected to set a £650 charge, the highest in the country.
I think that the contrast which my honourable friend gave will be even more effective when we compare Wandsworth with next door neighbouring Lambeth when they announce their community charge, which is rumoured will be very, very high indeed. We cannot say which councils will be charge capped. That is a matter for my right honourable friend, the Secretary of State. And he will make his decision when the time comes, but he will not hesitate to use his powers.
The Prime Minister was backed by Harlow MP Gerry Hayes.
It really is the most rank hypocrisy of left-wing Harlow Council to try and pin the blame of a £425 community charge on the government when they are the highest spending per head local authority in the whole of the country.
Demonstrations against poll tax in London are growing increasingly violent. Several hundred protesters tried to force their way into Haringey civic offices last night as councillors were trying to set a £573 charge. The rowdy demonstration forced the Labour-run council to adjourn the meeting until Friday. Meanwhile, Conservative MPs Toby Jessel and Jeremy Hanley are boycotting the opening of new council offices in Twickenham tonight in protest at Richmond's planned £395 poll tax. A big demonstration is expected as the Alliance-controlled council meets to approve the charge this evening. This is Jane Ball for Thames News.